Let's have a look at the code of the demo project. We're going to start with the UI Engine config file. This file contains the basic configuration for your project. It also contains some useful information on each of the config options. For now, let's focus on the source and target directories. These are pointers to separate directories where your components, templates, and pages live. Source pages points to a directory that contains the documentation site. Each documentation page can consist of two files. First of all, there's the README file. It is a markdown file which contains the page's content. For instance, here we are having a look at the home page. Then there's also the page config file. In this case, the file is empty because we don't need extra configuration for the home page. But let's have a look at one of the other page config files. For example, the configuration for the documentation page contains a list of child pages. By default, the UI engine infers the order of the child pages based on the folder names. You can use the children option to reorder child pages. We're going to switch to the browser to have a look at this. As you can see, there's the colors page, the fonts, and the spaces. Let's switch back to the editor and move the colors page to the end. As you can see, the interface auto-updated. That's because we are running the build command using the watch flag. The command line interface also lets us know that it just rebuilt the tokens page. Let's have a look at this once more by moving the colors page back to the front. And here we are. Okay, let's get back to the code. And we'll look at the details of the spaces page. This page contains a list of size tokens. It utilizes the tokens attribute. This is a special attribute used by the UI engine to know that now we are going to render some design tokens. The UI engine renders the design tokens depending on their type. This is what spaces and size tokens look like. In addition to that, there are also several other display modes like font tokens, color tokens, or icons. In this case, the color tokens are also categorized. Let's see how this can be achieved. The page config for the colors page also contains a list of tokens. But in this case, the first level is of type category. This is a special type that allows you to structure your tokens even further. Now that we have seen some details of the token pages, let's have a look at the pattern library part.